Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making stuffed peppers. And we're going to start with some bell peppers. I have green bell peppers. If you'd like to use the red or the yellow, you can do that, or you can alternate them however you like to have them in your dish. I'm doing four of them. So if you plan to do more, if you want eight, just double the recipe. For six, it'll be 1.5 times each ingredient and so on. Now I have hollowed these out because they're going to be stuffed with some meat and some rice and some spices. And they're going to look like this, and they're going to sit in a casserole dish, probably this one. And I will have them covered and I will bake them. But to get them prepared, what I need to do on this last one is to take a paring knife and I just go around the upper edge. And you need to be very careful with this. That has kind of a long stem that wants to get in the way. But just go around this edge. Let me see where I started. Right there. And when you finish your circle, lift that out. And I've got a paper towel here that I can put it on. When you lift it out, there are a lot of fibers that will come with it. And then the other fibers, you'll take your fingers or use the knife for the seeds. But somehow you're going to have to get all of that out. So I'm going to move over to the sink so I can use some water to splash in it too. And I'll come back with this one cleaned up and then we'll continue. The next thing that I need to do with my bell peppers that I've got hollowed out is to parboil them. So that means put them in enough water that they will soften a little bit after about 5 or 6 minutes. So I have water that is coming to a boil right now, and I'm just going to pick up all four peppers and place them right down in that water. I just put my bell peppers in the pot over there to parboil, and they're slightly boiling, so we're going to start mixing up part of the stuffing. Now this is 1 pound of ground beef, lean ground beef. It's 4% fat. So I'm going to put that in a deep skillet, or you can use a Dutch oven. To that, I'm going to be adding some chopped onion, and it's an onion about this size, maybe a little smaller. I would say a small to medium sized onion. And I just used a kitchen chopper. I think I'm going to need a spoon to get that out. And I have a rather large spoon here for stirring, so. Here we have our chopped onion. And also, I have on my cutting board there 1 clove of garlic to show you how much garlic I have minced. So you need some very finely chopped garlic. Now that goes in to your skillet. And then we go to the stove with all of this. And I'm going to take my larger spoon, chunk this up, and brown it while we finish up the parboiling of our peppers. So let me get this turned on. And when I see you back, I'll have this browned up, and the onions will have softened, and the flavor of the garlic will be permeating the meat, and we'll have our bell peppers draining. My scooped out bell peppers have boiled for about 5 minutes and they're nice and soft, but they're very hot. So those are draining upside down to get all of that water out of them. And in the meantime, we're going to be mixing up the stuffing. What we started with earlier, our ground beef and our onion and our garlic has been sauteed up on the stove. And with that, we're going to mix a few things. So the next thing that comes along is tomato ketchup. We need 1 cup of that, so that goes into our mix. Didn't think to use my tip, which is if you spray this with some cooking oil first, then it will slide out very easily. So I'm sure all of you will remember to do that. But 1 cup of tomato ketchup. Then you need tomato sauce. You need 4 ounces, that would be half of this. So I'm just gonna pour half of it in and I'll save the other half for something else. I always have a use for everything that I save back from a recipe. Now here we have Worcestershire sauce and I'm gonna use 1 tablespoon. So I have it measured out. Bring that over. And then I need a scant teaspoon of salt. So I've got it in a teaspoon measure, but not all the way to the top. So in between 1/2 and 1 full teaspoon, just somewhere in there. And then I've got 1/4 teaspoon of ground black pepper. You can see it's just the ground black pepper that you might normally use at your table. 1/4 teaspoon. All of this is going to be mixed together, and then it goes back to the stove and it simmers for 20 minutes. You need to get all those flavors blended really well before you try to do any stuffing. So what I'm going to do is put it on the back burner here, and you'll notice that I have, that would be on low. Might start a little higher to get it up to heat, and then I'll turn it to low. You might notice that I have some rice cooking right here. Now this rice was made from a package of long grain rice. This is white rice, and there is 1 cup of rice to 2 cups of water. So I boiled the water, put the rice in, and then when it came to a boil, again, I put the lid on and it boils for 14 or 15 minutes. And then it will be nice and fluffy and ready to go together with this mix. So we're going to work on that right now and let it simmer for 20 minutes, and the rice will get done in the meantime. So here's where we are. I've been simmering this mixture for 20 minutes, and you can see it's nice and together. And I've made my white rice. I described it to you earlier, and it's nice and fluffy. It just got done, it's nice and steamy. So we're gonna mix these two together, and that's gonna form the stuffing for our green bell peppers. So there we go on the rice. We're through with that. Now, I put my bell peppers in a casserole dish that had a lid, because this will have to be covered. If you don't have one with a fitting lid, then cover it with aluminum foil very tightly, because this is going to bake in the oven. I also sprayed with a cooking oil spray. It's canola oil. Use whatever you like there. And each one of these is going to be stuffed once I get this mixed together. So give me a second here. I'll have it together and I'll start stuffing those. I've been stuffing my green peppers, and you can see that I'm on the last one here, and I'm making these pretty full, although what I'm going to do is bake them for 25 minutes and then bring them out of the oven for a second or two and put some cheddar cheese on top of them and let them go back in the oven for about 3 minutes or so to let the cheese melt. So you'll notice that I have quite a lot of stuffing left over. I'd say probably it's more than half used, but there's a good amount left. It has a good flavor, and you can add it to a lot of different things. You could stuff more peppers if you wanted to. So I'm just letting you see what an average size pepper, if you have 4 of those, what this amount will fill. And if you want to use 6 of this size, I think that would have worked very well. So this goes in the oven, and I'll let you see it after the cheese is already melted on the top. These are our finished stuffed peppers, and you can see the cheesy top. And what we did here was to bake this in the oven at 375 degrees for 25 minutes, and then we put cheese on and back into the oven for 3 minutes, and I turned it on the broiler for the last one of those minutes to let it broil off just a little bit. So I'm going to take a couple of spoons here and go down and dig one of these out and put it on a serving plate. So I'm just bringing it over here, and for display I'm just going to put another one beside it. So let's take this one and move these along, and I think those are not going to fall over. So I have a little bit of celery hearts here for display. And then over here earlier in the day, we made 2 cheese grits. So there was Parmesan cheese and also Romano cheese in the grits. So you might enjoy eating that along with your stuffed peppers, and have your nice glass of iced tea, of course.